Hi Libra, welcome to Mirake the Tribe. My name is Ayushi and this is going to be for November 2018 for Libra Sun, Moon and Rising. Guys, this is a general reading, so kindly take what resonates with you and leave the rest. Also, use your own intuition while you listen to these messages. It may apply to your situation differently. Also, this can be happening to you or someone around you. So let's see what's coming up for Libra. Okay, the first card out for you is the Eight of Swords, and the bottom of the deck is Sun of Wands. So what I'm getting right now here is that you're feeling very stuck in a situation or in your mind. Basically, you are not able to move in a way that you feel that I don't know which way to go, because you feel that there is a process which is not completing. So you might feel that you are stuck in between something that is not completing or it's not coming to an end. Sun of Swand is someone who is probably influencing this. Basically, this person is telling you that they like you or something of that nature, but they don't offer commitment. They can be a little bit immature. You can be dealing with a Leo, Sag, Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising. This person is paying attention to you and is very fixated on you, or you are this, like you are fixated on a particular situation where you are feeling very stuck. So that is the energy that I am getting right now. The solution to how you can remove yourself from a situation which is not moving forward or which is not dissolving in your favor, it's basically by letting things be, letting that, like accepting the situation as it is and not live in denial. Once you will accept the situation the way it is, you might have certain perception develop in you where you will be able to see how you can opt for something that would turn in your favor. But as long as you are stuck in a cycle, you are not able to see beyond it. So until unless you accept the situation that yes, I am stuck here because of this, because of my this decision, until unless you accept that, you are not you won't be able to move past it. And like I said, you could be dealing with somebody who is not helping you in a way that this person is not cooperating. Can be a little bit immature with the way that they deal with the situation. So what are the messages coming in for Libra for November 2018? 10 card Celtic Cross. Okay, let's begin. So yes, this is your energy right now in the center of the reading, which is again that you're feeling liberated and recognized for your work, and you're feeling that you have achieved something that you were working on. You feel that you are being liberated from something, and you can fly past it. You can move away from the situation which was restricting you, and you can feel liberated. Now the card, bottom of the deck is the World card. When I started doing your reading, Libra, the World card was at the bottom of the deck at that point as well. So definitely you are ending a cycle, some of you. Give me a moment, I'll show you the card which flipped out for you, which was Eight of Swords. So every time I get an Eight of Swords energy, I definitely get Six of Wands energy after that. Just give me a moment, I'll show you. This is going to be a little bit difficult to find that card since I shuffled it. Okay, I got it. So this was the energy that flipped out for you. So every time I get this card, I definitely get this card as the next card, which is this butterfly here is in cocoon, and this butterfly is liberated. So once you give yourself a chance to, let a energy pass and let the process complete in its own time, you will be liberated. And it will take some time, but ultimately you can emerge out as a butterfly and be done with the situation which was holding you back. Now let's see what's crossing it. The crossing card is Father of Wands. So earlier you had the Son of Wands, now you have the Father of Wands as crossing card. So definitely you are dealing with a fire sign, Leo, Aries, Sag, someone of that nature. This person can be very bossy and very much self-centered. They need a lot of attention, and they need they are quite needy when it comes to attention. They want all your attention on them. So you might be facing some problem with the fact that you are not getting any recognition and this person is wanting all your attention. This can be you as well, like you are hogging the limelight or something like that. Or someone is obstructing your limelight. That's the message that I'm getting right now. What's the root of this reading is the Father of Cups. So this is someone who is not expressive when it comes to emotions, but they do feel all the emotion, but they are not expressive. This person is very cool, calm, collected. They know how the other person is also feeling, and they understand everybody, but they act with their rational mind. They take into consideration everybody's feelings. So this can be you or the person that you're dealing with. This is a Four of Swords in the past energy. So you were trying to heal something, you were trying to heal from something in the past, or you were trying to heal someone. You could have been a little bit in a place of aha moment, basically, where you felt like, oh, okay, I just realized this. And you were going through some sort of realization in the past, and you were trying to assimilate or contain that knowledge that you had gained, and you were trying to meditate on that information or idea that you had in the past. So there was some revelation in the past that you had. And then this was also the card that I got before I switched on the camera for you, Libra. Now, Ten of Pentacles. This is the card where you want a family union, you want a family, you want complete bliss, you want to share your, you have a flourishing family idea, goal, legacy. This is the card for that. Everything is aligned, everything is functioning really well in the flow, and prosperity, abundance, basically that is what is on your mind. So you might not have this, but this is what you are aiming for, completion and fulfillment, basically. This is Daughter of Pentacles in the future. So in future I see that you are working in the background, and either this is you or someone else. This person is working in the background. They are focused on something that they are doing, and they are planning really well about how to execute their ideas. Okay, one more thing. When it comes to work, some of you are working very hard, and you will be working really hard on an idea which you were already sitting upon for a very long time. Like you had an idea, you were not doing anything about it, but now you want to make that idea something like you want to bring that idea to everybody's attention, and you want to work for that idea so that you can make enough money to live the lifestyle that you want. And you also need require some fame, basically some recognition, and there is someone who is obstructing you. Now this can be you yourself obstructing yourself because you don't feel confident enough, because you don't believe in yourself enough, because you don't feel enthusiastic or assertive enough or decisive enough, or you feel that you're not charismatic enough, or you find it hard to be in the spotlight because you are an introvert. So that sort of energy is there. But you come up in this reading as a Father of Pentacles, and then your surrounding card is the Five of Pentacles, and then your hopes and fears is the Emperor. Your outcome card is the Ace of Wands. So the outcome is really nice. The outcome is telling me that even though, however the things may turn out, by the end of this month of November, you will still have something to work upon. You will still have an idea, a enthusiasm, a spark within you to take your idea forward. So you will be feeling motivated and energetic by the end of the month of November. And you will be in fact inspiring other people. This can also mean that someone is going to be attracted towards you, but that's a different story. It can also mean that you for some of you, that you will have a you know, in your family you will welcome a child, like, you know, a new member. You're adding someone to the family, something of that nature. And then Father of Pentacles here is telling me that you're very responsible. You want to be very very much in control of your finances, and you are very resourceful and very, very, very responsible. Like, when it comes to emotions, you are very responsible. When it comes to finances, you want to be very, very responsible. You don't want to be caught up in immature stuff. You want to be mature. What I'm also getting here is that if there are two people, actually I see three to four people here, but if there are two people and you have a choice, I think some of you are just going to leave somebody out in the cold, or someone is leaving you out in the cold. Now, this entire thing feels very passionate and very sexual to me. In the month of November, I feel that there is some attraction at workplace as well. Like, someone is fearing or hoping or dreaming about their boss. Yeah, that's what I'm getting here. So I'm also getting here that someone is scared of their boss. It almost feels like Me Too situation. If, like, somebody is like, you know, it's basically someone is going through a phase where somebody is pressurizing them to work for them in a certain way for certain favors and something of that nature. Like, someone is asking for sexual favors, that, like, pressurizing someone. Not just like it doesn't have to be sexual favors, but it feels like that because this is what I'm getting here. This is the Ace of Wands. This is the Emperor, which is almost a very bossy card. And since we have this card as the crossing card, which is Father of Wands as the challenge, this person can be really, really arrogant and bossy. And then this card, which is someone wants to be recognized, like someone needs a promotion, someone needs to be appreciated for their work. So yes, I think that is coming up. And I'm also getting that someone's credit might be taken away. So you are fighting for that, like, you want to have your dues. I'm getting that if you were like, either you will leave somebody out in the cold, like you will tell them no, and then they will have to go through a lot of sorrow and pain, or this is you, you have been left out by someone, or someone has left you out in the cold. Someone is definitely feeling cold. But what I'm seeing here is that whoever is feeling financially not so well, or who is feeling left out in the cold, you are taking care of this person, or you can take care of this person if you wish to, because I think you are quite well to do right now. I think you want to end a situation which is almost over for you, and you want to move forward. Yeah, you want to move forward because you know that something has come to an end. So there is no point dragging it along. So you are in a process of letting things be and letting things unfold naturally. I'm also getting here that that in future you are just focused on your work. Like, dedicated towards your work. Now, this turned out to be a work reading for me, but those were the messages that I was getting. And then a Nine of Swords with the Three of Pentacles, which is again a work card. So someone is definitely worried about their work and finances. So that was your reading, Libra, but I'll be pulling out few more cards, so wait for that. So what is the message for Libra for November 2018? By the way, in India, because this is a Libra season and it's strange that I'm doing a Libra reading and that's when I'm getting this sort of message where it's about Me Too, the hashtag Me Too. So in India currently, Me Too India is going on, and a lot of people are coming out about the abuses that they are facing and they have faced in past so many years. So it was quite strange for me to do this reading, and then within the Libra reading, which was this reading, and the season is Libra season, and getting the message. I never thought that I'll do a reading like that. Forgiveness. So maybe, give me a moment, guys. Yeah, so maybe there is someone asking for your forgiveness, or you have to forgive someone, or you have to forgive just your own self for something that you did not do. Yes, sometimes, like, I'm getting that you did not do something and that's why you need to forgive yourself. Something of that nature is coming up. I'm also getting that someone needed your help regarding a situation where you needed to support someone and you did not come out to help them or support them. For some of you, that's the message that I'm getting, and that's why you need to forgive yourself that, okay, I did not, like, you feel guilty that you did not come out to support them or something like that, but you need to forgive yourself for that, and gratitude. For some of you, I feel it. This person was considering you their friend. It can go any which way. Like, you can be the other person who needed help probably, and there were people who were watching you that they knew that you needed help, but they did not actually come out to help you, and now you need to forgive them. They will not ask for forgiveness, but you need to forgive them. You don't have to take them back in your life, but you need to forgive them and let the situation go, and have gratitude for people who were there to support you, and now you know that who is with you and who is not with you. I'm also feeling here that someone around you is either pregnant, or you are having some idea which is taking birth in you. So you need to give that idea a chance. Now let me draw one more card from this deck. See the true you. Seeing the true you. Seeing the true you. Very beautiful card. So I think you are realizing few things about yourself, and I think you need to give yourself a little bit break, like a coffee break. If that's what you can afford, then you can do, like, you need to just sit down with people who really, really care about you. And the another card for you is the Sacred Fool. So the last card that we had as your bottom of the deck was the World card, and getting Sacred Fool from this deck makes it clear that you are starting a new journey. Some of you are starting a spiritual journey, and you are looking for yourself, and you are asking questions like, who am I, what is the purpose of my life, and some of you are actually appreciating the universe. So you are feeling very, very grateful for the life that you have, and the opportunities that you have. And in case you are not feeling like that, you should start feeling like that. Once you start feeling for something, like you truly believe that you are blessed, you will actually get reasons for feeling blessed. So don't be in a very pity zone. Don't be in that zone. Don't pity yourself. Do something to elevate yourself. So that was your message, Libra. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you next month. Bye bye.